In the previous video, that is plant tissues part 1, we have seen and studied about meristematic tissue in detail. And in this video, I will be mentioning the function and characteristics of permanent tissues. What are permanent tissues? The tissues that are completely grown and have lost the ability of division are called permanent tissues. The meristematic tissues divide and differentiate to form the permanent tissues. Permanent tissues are a group of cells which are similar in origin, structure, and in function. There are three types of permanent tissues: simple permanent tissues, complex permanent tissues, and special or secretory tissues. I will be mentioning the types of permanent tissues one by one. First is simple permanent tissue. These are also known as homogeneous tissues. Homogeneous means uniform, as they are made up of a single cell type, usually with the same origin, structure, and function. There are three types of simple permanent tissues: parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. You can also see the structure and diagram of these tissues in the adjoining figure. First kind of simple permanent tissue is parenchyma. The cells of parenchyma have an oval or round shape. The cell wall is made up of hemicellulose or cellulose. Cells are thin-walled. They have vacuoles and they have very small nucleus. It is found in all parts of the plant. The protoplasm of parenchymatic cells is living and dense. Second kind is collenchyma. Cells of collenchyma are long and thick-walled. The cell wall is made up of cellulose and pectin. It is the only tissue with the highest refractive index due to the presence of pectin. It is found in hypodermis of dicot stem and the vascular bundle of dicot leaf. The amount of chloroplast is less in the cells. The cells have no intercellular spaces. The cells of parenchyma and collenchyma are living. But in sclerenchyma, tissues are dead, they are very hard and rigid in texture. Cells are thick-walled with various size and shapes. Sclerenchyma provides mechanical support and rigidity to the plant. There are two types of sclerenchyma cells, fibers and sclerides. You can see the diagram of these two kinds in the given picture. Fiber is thin and elongated with the presence of lumen. Lumen is the inside space of a tubular structure, whereas sclerite is round in structure and there is presence of lumen in sclerite as well. Cell wall is thick and pits are also present. Now, after simple permanent tissues, I will tell you about the second category of permanent tissue, which is complex permanent tissue. The complex permanent tissues are made up of different types of cells performing diverse functions. There are two types of complex permanent tissues, namely xylem and phloem. The first type of complex permanent tissue is the xylem. Xylem transports water and nutrients from the roots to the leaves of the plant. It also provides support to the plants. The various parts of xylem are tracheids, vessels, xylem fiber, and xylem parenchyma. You can also see the diagram of a xylem vessel in the given picture. The water and nutrients are transported in one way only, inside the xylem vessel. The cell walls are thick and they are stiffened with lignin. There are no end walls between cells. The second type of complex permanent tissue is the phloem. Phloem translocates the prepared organic food from the leaves to different parts of the plant. Phloem is also known as bast. It is composed of sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers. You can see the diagram of phloem in the given picture. Unlike xylem, there is two-way flow inside phloem vessel. Cells have walls with perforations. These are some of the general functions of permanent tissues. In aquatic plants, these tissues help in floating. So they are known as aeronchyma. Or we can also say when parenchymatic cells help the plants in floating, they are known as aeronchyma because they have cavities in which air gets trapped. Permanent tissues also store food in the form of starch, proteins, oils, and fats. Permanent tissues provide hardness to fruits such as nuts, coconut, almond, etc. These tissues contain chloroplast, which helps in carrying out photosynthesis. They are known as chlorenchyma. Again, when parenchymatic cells contain chloroplast and they help in the function of photosynthesis, these parenchymatic cells are known as chlorenchyma. Permanent tissues are also involved in the secretion, transportation, and they provide mechanical support to the plants.